I'm Courtney Friel.
And I'm Rick Chambers. Welcome to the KTLA 5 News at 6:30. Let's go right to Steve Kuz. He's live in Glendora for us tonight. He's got the latest on the Colby fire. Hello, Steve.
Hey, good evening, Courtney and Rick. You know, the best news people out here in Glendora have heard all week is that these evacuation, these mandatory orders, have finally been lifted. It's over for now. And they're also, many people told me, extremely happy that their communities were saved. And yes, they are very grateful to the brave men and women of the firefighters who kept these houses safe. Of course, the Colby Fire definitely left a mark out in here. Let's talk about that. Among the 1,900 acres of land burned, it destroyed 16 structures. 5 of those were homes and family mansions. And at this time, we are still close to 1,400 firefighters in this area battling the blaze, along with the help of helicopters, bulldozers, and nearly 100 fire engines. In the last update, officials told us they had the Colby Fire around 78% contained. With most of the wildfire control, firefighters said the biggest challenge now is just dealing with the steep mountainside slopes. The hills make it quite difficult and somewhat dangerous for crews to build fire lines on foot. Homeowners I spoke with are definitely relieved to be back safely home. Some, though, were nervous that when they had to pack up and run from the approaching flames, that it would be the last time they ever saw their houses. Needless to say, neighbors, happy to be back to normal.
It's a big relief being back at home, so there's no doubt about that.
Definitely. Yeah, definitely. So, it's the biggest word.
Thank you to all the firefighters and police who helped organize and keep these fires under control. I mean, the helicopters and the planes were amazing. The stuff that they did to put these fires down and keep it controlled was simply amazing. So, thank you to them.
Well, the men law enforcement believe started the Colby Fire when their campfire got out of hand are Clifford Henry, Jonathan Jarrell, and Stephen Aguirre. Federal charges are expected to be filed against the trio of 20-year-olds later this week. I'll throw it back to you, Courtney and Rick.
All right, Steve, thanks for that report. Some residents in Venice are wondering.